mothers watching this video, you're doing an amazing job of raising your kids. I know it's very tough. And so is shedding your pregnancy weight. I know that because I had gained about 25 to 30 kgs during my pregnancy and a little after that about 2 years ago, and the journey has been quite tough. In this video, I'm going to talk about my experiences and my learnings on how to lose pregnancy weight in a healthy way. So when I say it's tough to lose pregnancy weight, I'm not just talking about the physical aspect. I'm talking more about the mental and the emotional aspect of it. You know, emotionally so much is happening inside you that it's probably losing weight is like somewhere last on your list. Motherhood is a time when people around you just expect you to be happy when you have your little bundle of joy in your arms. And probably that is the case, but nobody talks about the inner turmoil that a mother goes through. I remember when I had my baby, the first initial 2 months, they were just a blur. I think it took me a long while to just accept what has happened. And that was because, you know, I was just not in sync with my emotions mentally. There is a lot of joy, but with that, there is a lot of inner turmoil, inner dilemma, because your life has changed. You know, you no longer have time for yourself. You no longer can decide just for yourself. You have to eat according to what your baby wants, because you're breastfeeding and you have to take care of your baby. And you have to take care of so many other things except yourself, you know, like, because you just don't have time for yourself. And In this meanwhile, your body is growing because you're eating and you're feeling frustrated, you're feeling low on energy, then you go for that bar of chocolate, then you go for a cake or a pastry to make you feel better, and you just get some time for yourself, and in that also you just want to eat something nice to pep you up maybe. So now what do you do about it? What did I do about it? So I really understood and realized that to lose pregnancy weight and some more and to get healthy, I had to use a three-pillar approach, which is probably the guru mantra for losing the pregnancy weight. So the three pillars are emotional, nutritional, and physical. You have to work on these three aspects one by one. So let's talk about nutrition aspect first, because that is the most important. If you're breastfeeding your baby, so you have to eat according to what suits your baby. Obviously avoid gassy food and acidic foods and all. Have nice, light, lot of green veggies and all. So what I've researched is, in this period of time, your body needs a lot of alkaline food, which is anti-inflammatory. So you should have a lot of veggies like lauki, beetroot, carrot, pumpkin, bell peppers, broccoli, bananas, berries. All of these are alkaline food, which will make your system light. Then you need a balanced diet, which is a mix of some amount of protein, some amount of carbs, and a lot of healthy fats. So you need a lot of green veggies in your diet for sure. Then you need a good amount of soy products. You can have fish, nuts. Then you can have pulses, dal, and egg for protein. And healthy fats would be something from coconut oil, olive oil, avocado. You can include these in your diet. These really help you. And of course, have a lot of fruits, because fruits give you that fiber that your body needs. So have a lot of grape, banana, seasonal fruits, berries. Berries are very good. They are good antioxidants, good sources of antioxidants. Have those. And during this time, gas is really a problem, because you can have that. So a good solution for that is, you can make a mix of ginger powder, sonf, and hing. Just blend these powders together and have it either added to your food, or maybe just take a bit of it with water. That really helps in relieving gas from your system. So all in all, obviously, you know that you need to eat healthy, but just take stock of things that are to be avoided. Caffeine is strictly in moderation. If you feel like having a cookie or a, maybe a chocolate sometime, you can have it, but have it in moderation. Dark chocolate is a good replacement for the normal healthy, the normal sweetened chocolate. You can do that. You can give in to your indulgence a little bit because you know it's a tough time for you, but keep it in moderation. That is the key. So I know it's easier said than done. I know that you know for the first year I just had no control over anything, and you know everybody advises you to eat properly, eat for the baby, and of course you're eating for the baby. You know, even now when you're breastfeeding a baby, when the baby is like till two years or something, you're still breastfeeding, so you're eating, still eating for the baby. So you have to make sure that you get your proper nutritional requirements, and don't, you know, just don't rush into getting fitter and getting back to work, you know, in shape and all. So what I did was, for the first year when I had no control over things, I was eating whatever I was getting, and that was important. Like my mother was feeding me with nice chia parathas because that is helpful in lactation and all. So I had all of that. But I took that time to also research on how, you know, what my body needs and how I can slowly start getting healthier. So it was roughly after a year only when I started cutting back on the calories I was having. So I cut down a lot of roti and rice from my diet, but I made sure that I was having a good amount of greens. I was having a good amount of salads, veggies and fruits. And I started consciously cutting back on the junk food that I was having, because you know, like earlier I was still continuing to having on off, maybe occasionally or whatever, but I wasn't very watchful of the portions I was having. So now I became aware of the portions, and I just consciously made a decision to just cut that out slowly from my diet. And now I'm at a stage when you know, processed food and junk food are nowhere a part of my diet, and that is very, very essential. You know, you just stop eating out of the box, as they say. So replace that with good amount of, you know, you can snack on nuts in moderation, then fruits and green veggies and all. So that has to come in, and all the processed food and the junk food has to go out of your diet. So next comes the emotional aspect. You have to take care of yourself emotionally. Now, a lot of emotions are going through in your mind, you know, and you just distract yourself with television, and you see these perfect celebrity moms who are like, you know, just they've just delivered a baby, but they're just back in business with perfect hair, perfect makeup and everything. Then you look at social media, you know, your friends or maybe those Insta moms, they look so peppy and all prim and proper and back in shape just in no time. And you wonder if something's wrong with you. You know, that was happening with me, and I was wondering, okay, am I the only one going through postpartum depression? Because nobody talks about that, you know. It's just assumed that, you know, you've become a mother and you automatically know how to be a mother and you know how to be happy. But that is not the case usually, you know. You have to take stock of your emotions. There are a lot of hormonal changes going inside, and you're probably just crying for no reason at, you know, in the middle of the day. All this was happening with me, and these emotions were real. So I understood that if I have to get healthy, I'll have to you know, work on my emotions, the emotions aspect. How do you do that? So you need to take, if you have a support system, like I had my parents to take care of my baby. So then you can have like little time for yourself and use that not to eat some junk and, you know, make yourself feel better, but take up something that you like. Maybe meet a friend, maybe read a book or something that, you know, like just calms you down. What can also help you emotionally is the physical aspect, the physical part of it. What I did was, I used to go for these long walks with my husband. It's good to have a partner in handy who's, you know, who's ready to listen to you, either just vent out or maybe like, you know, just calm you, peace you out. In my case, I'm lucky to have a husband like that who was very supportive through my entire journey. So we used to go for these long walks. We started with very slow, not if it wasn't even brisk walks. We used to go to a nice park. There's a Nehru Park near when Lodi Park or Lodi Garden in Delhi, we used to go there. Why I mentioned these parks is because, you know, like if you go to a like nice huge park which is like full of greenery and flowers, it immediately calms your mind, it soothes you. So that, I think those walks really helped me get control of myself. And then of course later we started brisk walking. We used to go 1 hour in the morning and then 1.5 hour in the evening. So those really helped. I did not go gymming in that phase. It was only much later. It was recently that I joined gym, but I stopped that also now. But we still go for really long walks. You know, like walking a good 6 to 7 kilometers a day. You know, just dividing that out, that really helps physically and as well emotionally, because you know it can really heal you from inside. You can go for yoga, meditation, light exercises, gentle exercises in the beginning, and then you can, you know, start exercising rigorously like later on. When your body feels lighter, you anyway will feel like, you know, putting in some physical efforts therein. So to sum it all, how I lost 30 kgs after pregnancy is by this three-pillar approach, working on myself nutritionally, physically and emotionally. Emotionally, I would say that is the biggest and the most important part. In fact, that is one key takeaway from this video, that you have to stop feeding your emotions. If you're feeling low, if you're feeling depressed, don't reach out for that cake. You know, go to a park for a walk, listen to some nice music, or do something that, you know, like peps you up otherwise. So that is one major thing. Then remember that this is your journey. It's not something somebody else's. Do not compare your lives to anybody else, or you know, somebody you see on social media or the celebrities that we you know, that, like, look at. Just accept your body, love it, but know that you have to make strong lifestyle changes to get healthy and feel better. Thank you for watching this video, and we have this group, Health Me Health You, wherein we discuss all of these aspects. We have some members looking at losing out that pregnancy weight, there are other members. So we encourage you to join that group and also add in your friends. And it's a support group, it's a free group where we discuss ideas and our journeys together, and hope to inspire everybody around to get healthy. I'm also sharing some nutritional ideas on our blog, the link of which is mentioned in the description below. Please go through that, it will really help you.